Hello, and welcome to our second video tutorial on how to read and use VFR sectional charts as unmanned aerial system or UAS operators. This series of videos is brought to you by AmericaView, in partnership with the College of Natural Resources and Environment at Virginia Tech, the Virginia Cooperative Extension, and GeoTED UAS. My name is Daniel Cross, and I'll be your guide again. As you know from the first video, sectionals are maps used by pilots for visual flight navigation. As such, they contain a lot of information. In this video, we will cover the basic layout of a sectional and where to find important ancillary data. In this tutorial, we will assume that you are using a digital chart so that the map will most likely appear as one sheet of paper. However, if you're using a hard copy, then the map will be split in half, with each half on one side of the hard copy chart. Now, let's go to SkyVector. First, let's look at how to know which sectional to use. Each sectional will have a Metamap in the white border area. This Metamap is a map of all of the sectionals, with the one you are currently looking at marked with these diagonal lines. It also displays the tacks with these pink boxes. As you know, tacks are terminal area charts, which cover a smaller area where the conventional sectional is a bit cluttered. As you can see on the Metamap, each sectional is named after a city in its coverage area. In SkyVector, let's use the Cincinnati sectional, which is the sectional that includes Virginia Tech. Here we see the main title just under the legend. This is the one with the FAA seal. The sectional title is also listed both in the lower left and right-hand corners of the map. Next, we have the dates the chart is effective through under the legend. These dates reflect when the chart can be used, as well as when and if it has been updated. In this example, the Cincinnati sectional is the 98th edition and is effective from 0901 Zulu on the 22nd of June 2017 to 0901 Zulu on the 7th of December 2017. It also notes that the airspace has been updated as of the 22nd of June 2017, but other information is from the 27th of April 2017. This information is important, since a sectional can only be used as is during those dates. If you have an older version, officially, it can only be used if you have made any and all corrections manually. The next area of interest is the legend, which is found in the upper left-hand corner of the map. This will contain definitions of all the symbols on the map. If you have found something that you don't understand, check the legend for an explanation. The last subject for this video are the informational tables. On the Cincinnati sectional, these tables are relatively small, and all on the left-hand side of the map, but this is not always the case. Some sectionals require much larger tables, and they may spill over onto other parts of the map, but they will always be in the white border area. The first table is the blue list of controlled airports, those with operational towers. This table lists all airports that have at least a part-time control tower. The information we may want to use as UAS operators will be the airport name, the hours the control tower is open, the tower frequency, and the ATIS, or Automated Weather Station, frequency. The most important information this table will relay to you is whether an airport is in a controlled airspace at all times. Some airports will revert to uncontrolled airspace when the tower closes, which means we do not need a waiver to fly in that airspace after hours. The other tables useful to us are the blue and magenta special airspace tables. The blue tables list prohibited, restricted, warning, and alert areas. These are important since we normally cannot fly in these areas while they are active, without permission. The first table entry is the ID number, which are how the areas are also identified on the map. There will be a letter, followed by a number, and at times followed by another letter. The first letter identifies the type of special use airspace: P for prohibited, R for restricted, W for warning, and A for alert. If the ID ends with a letter, that means there are multiple special use airspaces overlaying one another. After the ID number, there is the altitude the special airspace is effective for. In this example, R6602 Bravo does not start until 4,000 feet AGL, whereas R6602 Alpha goes from the surface to 4,000 feet. Since we cannot normally fly over 400 feet AGL, this table tells us that we don't need to worry about R6602 Bravo or Charlie. The next entry is for the time of use. Many special use airspaces activate at different times of the day or year. Here we see that R6602 Alpha is continuously on from the 1st of May to the 15th of September. However, R6602 Bravo and Charlie are irregularly active. The only way to know if they're active is to check the notices to airmen or NOTAM. Now, if we go back to the altitudes, we know that R6602 Bravo and Charlie are above where we fly. So during the time R6602 Alpha is off, we can fly under the other two restricted areas. The magenta special use airspace table is for military operation areas, or MOAs. This table has the same information as the blue table, but instead of ID numbers, each MOA has a name, such as Farmville or Pickett. That's it for this video. Please continue to the next video in the series, where we will go over map symbology in more detail. Thank you for joining us, and fly safe.